In this video, we're going to be looking at some three-phase distribution boards from Lewden. When it comes to commodity products like these three-phase boards, it takes little extras to make them stand out from the crowd. And a three-phase distribution board range from Lewden features this, mainly in the form of flexibility. So we're going to start by looking at a basic three-phase board, and then look at some of the things that can be done to add to it to create greater flexibility. Stay tuned to the end of the video to see something just a little bit different from Lewden in this area. And by the way, if you're interested in circuit protection and would like to take a deeper dive into this subject, then please check out our free accredited CPD module that we've created on this area by clicking the link in the description below. So this is the base unit, and as you can see if I open it up, it's an 8-module board which gives you 24 single phase ways. Also available in 4, 12 and 16 module units, there's plenty of scope for even the largest installations. It's got this lovely light grey hammered paint finish, and the styling with the slight chamfers on the door here is really professional and appropriate for commercial and industrial settings. Opening it up, there's some points to make a note of in here. First of all, there's these extra large terminals on the earth and neutral bars, perfect for large incoming conductors, plus loads and loads of space for routing, dressing and connecting your cables. Looking at the protective devices that are in here, you can see there's a really extensive range of options available, all with an ICN rating of 10,000 amps. We've got triple pole, double pole and single pole devices in a broad range of nominal ratings from 6 to 63 amp in some cases. They're also available in types B, C and D, so you know that there's an MCB that will fit the purpose you're installing it for. Again, if you'd like some more information on what types B, C and D all actually mean and what they're used for, how an MCB works or where that ICN value comes from, please click the link in the description to check out our free CPD package on this subject. Now, one of the key things that I love about this three-phase board is the flexibility of it. You can see on the top and bottom of the board these panels which can be removed, and that makes it really convenient for drilling holes to bring your cables into the panel. But it also opens up the possibility of adding extension boxes, which, as you can see, is what we've done here. So this is a 4-module board that we've extended on the top and the bottom, and more on those in just a moment. There's one small detail that I'd like to draw to your attention here, and that's the robust blank that actually sits in there, much like a circuit breaker does, and prevents access to the live busbar terminals, which is a really neat solution. Looking at the top extension box, there's just a couple of examples here of devices that could be used. You've got this fantastic 63 amp type A three-phase and neutral RCD, which is going to be useful for all sorts of circuits. And also we've got this rather neat DIN rail mounted digital time clock, which could be used for perhaps outside lighting control or something like that. Then, down in the bottom extension box, there's space for metering equipment, which is a requirement in certain applications in order to conform to the building regs. In this case, it's been protected by these fuse holder devices. And over on the right here, we've got a three-phase Type 2 surge protection device, which is becoming more and more critical to getting circuit protection right. But I promised at the outset that we'd see something a little bit special now, and it's right here. Now, you may find yourself carrying out installs in environments where a higher than usual level of IP rating is required, and this is just an incredible solution. This is a three-phase and neutral board that has been made using elements of the TAIS CUBE range that we featured in previous videos. Now, because of that, it means that when the door is closed and latched, it's got an IP rating of 6.6, meaning it's dust tight and impervious to high pressure water jets. This is a distribution board that means business. Open it up, you can see inside it's made out of GRP instead of metal, giving it a corrosion proof aspect as well. And it's got all the usual options of breakers, blanks and RCBOs you'd expect to find inside any three-phase distribution board. Something that I really love about this is that to get inside and work on the wiring, you don't need to remove a front panel and lay it down somewhere. You can just slide these bars up on one side of the front and then it just hinges out and you can get inside there. Now, because this TAIS box is deeper than your typical distribution board, the chassis that holds all the MCBs and busbars has been mounted a lot further forward than it usually would be, with the consequence that it gives you a huge amount of room in the back here for your wiring and cables to be neatly routed and dressed in there. So there we go. Three-phase distribution from Lewden. With such a broad range of options and accessories, it would seem that if they don't make it for this range, then you don't need it. However, as always, we want to hear from you. What do you think of the three-phase equipment from Lewden that we've featured in this video? Have you spotted any details that you particularly like or that perhaps we've missed? As always, please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below, And once more, if you'd like to know a whole lot more about circuit protection in general and MCBs in particular, then please click the link in the description below to carry out your accredited CPD module and receive certification and credit for your annual hourly requirement. All that remains in this video is to say thank you very much for watching.